Hey guys, Marley here, and welcome back to another video. Today we are doing my venue build for the Sparked Wedding Challenge thing. I'm not expecting to win any prizes for this. This build is nothing special, but I did have a lot of fun doing it. So I was inspired by a Grecian wedding vibe, so kind of like all white, blue roofs, we're on the beach, that sort of thing. And I really wanted to make sure that this was, I kind of wanted to do like a mix between like classic and like modern, as well as just making this look like somewhere that I would realistically go and like realistically see in the real world. So I had a lot of fun working on that. I put in like a guest book and I put in dressing rooms and I did like a special like wedding thing. So there's definitely more stuff here than what you actually need for your Sims game, but I was going for more of like, if I was going to have a wedding here in real life, what would I want? And that was kind of the vibe I was going for, but it was a lot of fun. I really, really, really enjoyed creating this build today. I'm glad that I had the opportunity to do so, and it was overall just a really good time. But so, let's talk about updates to the channel, because I have been posting less frequently. That is just because my new work schedule is a little bit more rigorous than what I was doing before, so it is kind of hard for me to upload as much as I was. I have also started streaming over on Twitch, so if you want to check me out live, I'm trying to go live at least 3 times a week. I post about it on my Twitter, which is linked in the description. My Twitch channel is also linked down there if you want to go follow me so you can be notified when I go live. I've been playing a lot of Minecraft. I'm going to be playing today The Sims at around 3 p.m. EST. So if you're not watching this on the day it was recorded, that's irrelevant to you. But if you are, I will be going live probably very soon after you watch this video, so come check me out over there. Follow me on Twitter so you can get notifications every time I do, as well as over on Discord. I'd love to have you. We've been pulling about 5 people every stream, so it's a good time, small chat. I have a lot of energy and room to talk to everyone who shows up. So it is really fun, and today I was actually going to stream this build, but I wanted to finish it to do this video, so I don't know what I'll stream. I will probably stream, I'm planning to do a create a sim as well as a story portion for the challenge as well, just so I can upload one of each for funsies. So I will probably be working on the create a sim and doing the story, so if you want to watch me work on that, doing some machinima, some storytelling, come follow me on Twitch and we will be doing that today. But yes, so for this build I wanted to go, everything is very white, it's very marble, there are like curtains and fabric everywhere and there's greenery, and it's overall like I think a really beautiful build, and I was actually feeling really confident about it until I started seeing all the people who were doing like, I saw someone do like a volcano wedding and like all kinds of stuff that I'm just really not creative to do. So compared to that, this does not look good. Also, guys, if they are going to do challenges that happen primarily in the gallery and rely on the gallery for us to find each other's builds, why the heck have they not given us the ability to do custom thumbnails? Because I swear, the gallery thumbnail for this looks so bad. So if anyone who doesn't follow me just sees this on the gallery, they're gonna be like, wow, that's an awful build. Also, looks like the footage is paused here. I am sorry. I did get up a couple of times to make food, and it looks like that's what's happening here. So we're just staring at a blank screen. I am going to edit that out. Oh, no, I'm not. It's already back. JK, we're still going. I try to do these voiceovers in one go because it is easier for me to edit, but sometimes I don't catch, like, big breaks like that while I'm doing like the first round of editing, so then like while I'm doing this I have to go back and pause that video, blah 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 blah, but that's okay. It really is just a big skill to talk for 25 minutes without stopping, and sometimes you miss things in editing, but then you don't want to stop because you've already got your momentum and you don't want to go back and redo that. I'm very much inspired by, like, you know, like I started my channel based on like a couple of creators, so like I really love Little Simsy, really love Plumbella, but Little Simsy was, well, actually the English Simmer was my first Sims love, but Little Simsy was the first, like, speed build love, and I really took her vibes, I think, a little bit of just non-talking, non-stop about nothing, and I think that, like, that's kind of how it is. You learn from the creators you watched, and what you enjoyed about their content, you kind of mimic. And so, I used to be obsessed with speed builds. You guys can see here, I'm trying something different with the roof. I did record the building of the shell, however, I was recording apparently at bad settings for the new computer because the footage was so choppy that it was unusable. And even this is a little choppy. Oop, like right now, what was that? I don't know. Epilepsy warning. If you have seizures, this video might not be for you. But I was trying to be more conscious. I recorded like the shell, and then the footage was like completely bad and it didn't work. I had also already done a lot of this, and then I accidentally didn't save the game, and I think that my first version was better, but it's okay. I made some changes. I added like a more public bathroom. I made the kitchen a lot smaller, so I don't know. I'm really proud though of the dock where like you actually would get married with all the plants and the pillars and the curtains. I think it's a really, really, really beautiful spot for your Sims to get married. So even if you don't care about all the other stuff I put in, if you're looking for a place where you can get like really good screenshots of your Sims getting married, I highly recommend. I uploaded the little dock portion as a room on my gallery. So you can go find me on the gallery. My name on the gallery is MarleyNicole123. And if you go find me on there, you can find just that little portion as a room, so you could really stick it anywhere. It does look really good over the water, but it would look good probably in any world, like peeking through those curtains, like the sunlight coming in, all the flowers. So if you wanted just that part, you can download just that separately. Because, I don't know, some people, if you don't really, like, play the game for the story, you might not care about all these other things where you could, like, have your Sims get ready together and have, like, a dress reveal and have, like, they have a special table where they can sit and cut the cake, and the other Sims, like, sit at those other little tables. Those things are kind of more for people who just care a lot about, like, telling a story, or maybe you want to make your Sims a wedding video. That could be fun. Stuff like that, if you don't necessarily need that, just the dock is available, and it's my favorite part of this build. So if you don't want the whole build, I highly suggest checking out the dock, because it is one of my favorite things I've ever made. It's my favorite wedding spot I've ever made, for sure. And I've tried to do that idea quite a few times, where it's kind of like a curtainy, pillary, kind of boho, flowery wedding vibes, and I don't think I've ever quite gotten it right, but this time I feel like I got it right. Also used pretty much every pack in this build, because I really wanted it to feel complete, so I was using whatever I thought fit the best. And you can see I'm putting down menus in some places from Dine Out. I'm putting down the drink trays from Eco Living, because I think those look great. I'm putting down decorations from all the packs, doors from the base game, counters from the base game. It uses, obviously, you need Island Living, because this is built in Sulani. I know it uses Eco Living, that's Parenthood Table, those are City Living chairs. So if you don't have all the packs, I am so sorry. Maybe I will try to do a base game version for this, but instead of doing one wedding picture like this, maybe I'll do... Ooh, that might not be good. I have another idea to do, like, an apple orchard venue, but the thing is that the apple trees in the game are so small. Maybe I could size them up. I don't know. I might work on that and have that one, like, be, like, a fall wedding, as opposed to this more, like, summer, like, we're outside, there's party space, places to drink wedding. And you can also see, like, I did try to add some stuff in there, because, like, in my mind, this venue wouldn't be just the wedding. You would also, like, stay here for, like, a few nights and have, like, a vacation wedding, because it's a destination wedding. So the vacation part is linked... kind of like there's a honeymoon suite that your Sims could stay in, and if you wanted to have more guests, obviously, you know, you could convert some of these spaces to have extra rooms. It would have been really cool if I did little cabins out on the water, but I didn't think of it in time, so it's not there. But now that I think of it, maybe I'll go back and add that. But I've already submitted the build, so who knows, maybe I'll just do it for the gallery. But like, you could have your Sims who are getting married like stay here, like, stay the night, have, like, a really nice, like, honeymoon night, and then also, like, have the wedding here, and it's really nice for that, like, kind of, like, your whole family shows up, they stay all day, you guys have a party, you have a barbecue, you eat, then everyone goes home, gets ready, takes a nap, they go back to, like, wherever they're staying, in their hotel or whatever, and they all take a nap, you know, they get dressed, and they come back, and the wedding is at sunset over the water. That's what I'm envisioning. For the story part, I do have, like, an idea in mind of where I want to go. I have an idea of the Sims. I think I want to have, like, a tragic, like, cheating story. So, if you're expecting a beautiful wedding from this venue, don't be expecting it from me, hunty. Because I think we want to go tragic. We want to go full drama. Anyway, now we are working on the dressing rooms. So in these dressing rooms, I did go very traditional colors. So there is a pink one and a blue one, but obviously that is up to your discretion how you wish to use them. Anyone can use either dressing room. I just wanted to have two of them. There are usually two people getting married. You know, when you get married, you know, there could be more or less, I guess, but typically I would say the majority of the time there are two people getting married. So We have two dressing rooms. One is pink, one is blue, but that does not mean that one has to be for the girls, one has to be for the boys. I think it's a really cute aesthetic for wedding venues to have that kind of, like, traditional color scheme. It's something that I would look for. I think it's really adorable, even though I don't subscribe to forcing gender roles on people, blah, blah, blah. I just think it's cute. So that's what I went with, because at the end of the day, this is for me, and I'm going to use it in my game, so... If you don't like it, you can change the wallpaper. You can make them both cream colored, and then it could be for anyone. But this is the pink dressing room. It has a women's mannequin also. I thought it would be cute if you could put, like, your wedding dress on the mannequin before the Sims actually get married. So maybe they're having the day at the beach first. Your wedding dress is on the mannequin, and then they go in, they put it on. Everything's nice. The other one has a mannequin also, so you could put either, like, another wedding dress, or you could put, like, a tuxedo. You could put whatever you wanted on the other one, you know, or you could put whatever you want on this one. I'm not telling you how to live your life. Dang, more pause footage. I thought I just cut all this out. Wow. Editing Marley is just doing so bad today, clearly. Apparently I was taking a break. Maybe I was feeding the dogs or something. But now we are putting in some bathrooms. So these bathrooms are really cute. They're some of the best bathrooms I've ever made, because I don't usually work hard on bathrooms. But I was trying to think of, like, bathrooms I've seen in fancy public places, and so that's what these are based off of. They have, like, a separate sink area, and then a little toilet with, like, a chair and, like, a trash can, and just, like, very nice things that you might find. I also shrunk down that thing from Eco Living that holds towels and put it over there, and I thought that that ended up looking really nice. Both of the dressing rooms have a place to get drinks. There is alcohol all over this venue, so if you're having a sober wedding, you might want to do it somewhere else, or you're going to have to delete a lot of bars. But I did not make this lot of bar. I did make it a generic lot type, so you could pretty much, or I made it a beach lot. So there won't be a bartender there. You'll have to hire one yourself, but I mean, that's kind of realistic, isn't it, for a wedding? Like, you would have to hire your own bartender, as far as I know. So that is there, but there are bars all over. There's globe bars, there's drink trays, there's tons of stuff. There's also the catering table from Vintage Glamour. Was it Vintage Glamour? No, Luxury Party Stuff, which is probably the worst stuff pack, maybe second to My First Pet Stuff that's ever been created in The Sims 4. However, the buffet table is perfect for weddings, because you don't actually have to cook. You can just fill up the fountain and fill up the table for, like, 50 simoleons, and then your Sims don't have to do any work. But if your Sims do want to do some work and you need to bake a cake or something, there is a full-service kitchen here as well. You can see now those two dressing rooms. You can see, like I said, they're both pretty generic. They both have the little tables where you sit at and, like, do your hair and makeup. They both have dressers, I think, so you could pretty much, like, you don't have to use those. If you're not being a storyteller, you don't even need those in the game at all. I just think they're fun. I think it's fun to try to, like, make a day of it, and I definitely have some Sims in mind to get married here in the future. And then you can see here, I decided to leave this in, but I do in a second start working on how to make the gallery picture look better, because the gallery picture looks like crap. So you'll see me, like, saving it and, like, adjusting the lot, and then saving it and adjusting the lot, like, trying to test it. Originally I had this little, like, beach section out here with some stuff for the kids to do, but then I saved it to the gallery and realized how god-awful it is, so I deleted it. And over here we're working on this master suite. So this master suite has, like, a little living room at the bottom. It connects to a private pool. If you wanted your Sims to stay here and not be bothered, all you would have to do is just lock. There is a gate, like, on that little pathway, so you would lock the gate, and then your Sims will be the only people who are allowed to get in. They have a private pool, they have a private bathroom, and, like, a big, like, suite with, like, a bed. There's a little coffee bar out there, because I thought it would be fun if you wanted to, like, make your coffee and sit by the private pool and, like, have, like, I don't know, like, if you were having, like, a weekend vacation here for your wedding, you know, you would, like, make your coffee, you would sit by the pool, you would, like, watch your friends and family, like, have a swim, you might go hang out for a while. There's also, like, an outdoor shower, so after you get out of the pool, you can rinse out before you go back inside. Here's a little coffee bar, kind of in a weird spot, but I figured, you know, if I had a suite for my wedding, that's the kind of thing I would want, so it's included. And then, what else do we have? Oh yeah, there's the gate I was talking about, so you can lock it so only your Sims can get in. By default, this is a beach lot, so you could visit at any time with any of your Sims if you wanted, and just have them hang out, and I think that's good, because there are, like, kind of, I don't know, I feel like at really fancy beaches, you do have buildings like this where you could maybe, like, rent towels, you could buy food, and it means that your weddings will feel very full, because there will be lots of people here no matter what. You could also just change it to a generic, change it to a bar, It works as a bar, it works as a generic, might work as a nightclub, it has a DJ table. So there are like very minor changes that would need to be made, but you could use this as a bunch of different lot types if you really wanted to. But obviously I made it specifically for weddings. This master suite is really cute. I ended up moving the chairs up there because I didn't think you could actually get into the pool if they were down by the pool. And I'm fixing the roof. I'm taking screenshots, I'm adding windows. I love the way it looks from that angle. I think it looks really, really nice from there. Yeah, the place I just took 2 screenshots. I love the water too. I've never been able to play with The Sims on high graphics until I got this new computer. So the water looks amazing. And then I added some more greenery. It doesn't really make sense that the vines would grow like only on the corners of specific spots of the build, but they do. And here's where I was talking about. I was saving it, trying to get the gallery picture to look better. If you know the struggle, it is real, but I leave it in because we all get it. All of us understand that the pictures of the gallery just don't do your build justice. You really gotta go in there and take a look for yourself before you start judging the builds. You gotta click play and see what you can find. But now I'm just doing basically like minor adjustments. I'm fixing the roof, I'm fixing the lot, like placement. I'm putting in like maybe trash cans or paintings or plants to make like a little different. I also did this bathroom. This bathroom doesn't have a sink, but not my problem. Wash your hands in the tub if you're really worried about it. I don't know. It didn't fit and I wanted the big tub. And then over here, I did something kind of weird. That's kind of like a plate and cup cabinet, I guess, if you needed like an extra plate or an extra cup or silverware. And it also has like condiments. So like ketchup, mustard, salt, and pepper. I don't know. That may be weird, but I kind of liked it. And here is just kind of like a game room. Maybe if you have like kids at the wedding who you really don't like, they're bored. Like it's after you got married. It's during the party portion. And they're like bored. They can play foosball. There's some games in there. There's a stereo. You can put on different types of music. Because, like, you know, people bring kids to weddings, and I think you need, like, a kid room at some point. There's also a bar in there, though, so maybe not. Maybe it's a teen room. And then I'm just zooming around, saving it, making it try to look better in pictures. I'm changing the lot type. So these are really just finishing touches. And we are coming to close to the end of this. So, guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for coming to my channel. I really appreciate you all here. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Please go look at my build on the gallery. I'm not asking you to vote for me, just asking you to check it out and give me a chance because I don't have a lot of gallery follows. Also, follow me on the gallery at MarleyNicole123. Link is in the description. We are now going to get into some machinimas of the build so you can get a better view of it, as well as some music, you know, to set the mood. So I will see you guys shortly. Again, like and subscribe if you enjoyed. Follow me on the gallery. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Twitch because I will be streaming today. And I am excited to seeing you guys next time. Have a good one. Goodbye.